Hi, my name is Caroline Vaughn, and I'm a badminton coach at the National Sports Council, and I've been working at the agency for 31 years. I have been playing badminton for over 35 years, and I started my badminton at age 12 at the St. James Secondary School with a teacher called Mr. Winston Skinner. He introduced the sport to me in a regular games period, and I somehow found it very easy. For me, my first passion was volleyball, but then when I picked up badminton, I somewhat recognized that badminton seemed so much easier. And then he introduced me to Mr. Reynolds Rouse, who took me from the beginner's level right up to my junior national ranking. My first tournament for Barbados as a junior player was in Guyana in 1985. I started coaching badminton in 1989 at the said Sports Council, where I was asked to coach, or if I wanted to coach badminton. I was a little hesitant at first, but then with lots of courage from my mates and my parents and stuff, then I decided, yes, coaching is what I want to do. What drives me most as a coach is just seeing children just starting the sport of badminton and seeing the delight on their face when I turn up at the school or at a club session and see kids running to me wanting to say, "Coach, coach, you're here today." That is what drives me as a coach. My experiences as a player allowed me the opportunity to go to countries like Mexico, Guatemala, United States, Manchester, England, Puerto Rico, because for me, I use it also as a tool to see the world. With sports, you get to see the world. It's the only opportunity you see the world through sports. And that was one of the reasons why I too saw myself as a badminton player and tried to keep on top of my game, because I wanted to see badminton at many different levels outside of Barbados. I had the opportunity to take a couple players to the regional tournaments, where I saw all of the under 11 and under 13s that we took to the tournament in Puerto Rico, all of them came back with medals. And for me as a coach, that was an achievement, because my love for the sport is more at the base end of the sport, where I prefer to work with the beginners and then pass them on to someone where I see their development. I've had two players who would have been to under 11 Caribbean finals. One was Nathan King, and the next one was Russell Butcher. Also, I would have had the opportunity to work with some other players who today themselves are coaches, namely Shakira Waif or Thelson Ford. So in all, as a coach, my task is having people start the sport and see them grow from strength to strength, and to develop people, not only develop badminton players, but to develop character, that in another 20 years and someone decides, "Well, I don't feel like playing badminton anymore," well, I can say, "Well, look, I had a hand in Shakira, I had a hand in a few players," and then that gives me the joy to know that at least I made somebody's life happy. One of the memorable moments for me as a coach is to see a young person that I took from age 7 or 8 and made her to be an under 11 champion. And she went on to represent Barbados. She competed at Junior Pan Am. She competed at Commonwealth Games. She competed at Pan Am Games. She competed at CAC Games. But what makes me happy as a coach who would have touched her life in a playing way is to see that she recognized the importance of being a coach and she took the task. Now she is the highest qualified coach we've got in Barbados. And for me, I feel great about that, because I would have started her badminton. Whenever she introduces people to me, she always says, "This is my first badminton coach." And for me, that is a love that I have. That is something that makes me feel really warm on the inside, to see that not only as a coach, but players welcome the feeling that they appreciate what I've done for them. My most memorable moment as a player was when I went to the CAC Championships in Guatemala, and I partnered with Argyle Maynard, and we won the gold medal at that tournament. It's one that stays with me from that day in 1993 until now, because no other players from Barbados have ever won a medal past that level. So I think for me as a player, it was my biggest achievement within the sport that I keep within me, that drives me to be the best player or the best coach that I can be. The advice I would give to young aspiring players is if you want to play badminton or any sport, it starts with discipline. You have to be disciplined, whether it's discipline on the court or off the court. You have to be committed. Commitment comes from you have your schoolwork, but you also have to make that extra sacrifice to make sure that you are on top of your game. Whether it's getting up on mornings before school, hitting the courts, or after school, just getting to your training venue and putting in your work. You have to be committed to the sport. You have to love the sport. If I had the power to change one thing in my sport, it would to have a 24-hour facility. Right now in Barbados, that is one of our major downfalls. We have the gymnasium, but right now with COVID, we haven't had the opportunity to use a couple of our play facilities. The reason why I would want to have a 24-hour facility is because for me, the sport goes beyond the court. For example, if someone is at lunch and they want to say, instead of going to the gym, let's go book a court and we can have that same hour. You get up on mornings, you go to the court, hit the courts, get yourself ready for work, same for school. Players commit themselves to training before school and after school. If I really had to say in a nutshell that I love my sport, badminton is the best sport. And for me, it made me the person I am today.